What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys how to get Nintendo Wi-Fi connection working on your Nintendo DS, DS Lite, DSi, or 3DS, so that you can play old classic DS games online with people anytime. And this setup uses no hacks whatsoever. It's very simple, straightforward, and I'm going to show you all the steps you need to get it done. But before I get started, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel because it helps the channel out a lot, and I also make lots of videos just like this that you don't want to miss. So guys, to get started, go ahead and get out the DS that you're going to use. You can see here I have a DS Lite, but I'm also going to show you how to do it on the DSi and 3DS. It's a very simple setup, and it's very similar across devices, with just a few things that are different, and I will show you each and every one. But go ahead and get any online game that you're going to use, and put it into your DS. So we got our game in, now let's go ahead and go into the device, go into your game. So I am now into the game, and you are going to see in whatever game that you choose, there is going to be a menu if it is an online game that says Nintendo Wi-Fi Connection, and we're going to go ahead and go to that. And then you'll see a menu like this, and we're going to go to Nintendo Wi-Fi Connection settings right there. And it'll bring you into a setup menu like this. We're going to go into Nintendo Wi-Fi Connection settings. So guys, once you click onto that menu, you'll see a screen that looks like this. Although you may have connections in 1, 2, or 3. If all of them are filled up, just erase one of them. Or if you have none like me, or just one that happens to be open, just go ahead and choose that one. For me, all of them are open, so I'm going to choose connection 1. Go ahead and search for an access point, and you'll see your Wi-Fi network show up here. Now, it is important to note that the original DS and DS Lite cannot use WPA networks. They can only use Wi-Fi networks that do not have a password or are secured with WEP security. So if you are using a Nintendo DS or DS Lite for this, your network is going to have to be WEP or unsecured. And if you don't have one of those, you can set up a phone hotspot that doesn't have a password so that you can do this. But if you are using a DSi or newer, you can use any network, whether it's on WPA or WPA2 or whatever network it is. You can use it as long as the game is DSi enhanced. And this will work on literally any of the consoles that are newer than the DSi. So any Wi-Fi will work with the DSi and newer consoles such as the 3DS and 2DS. If the game is not DSi enhanced, you're going to need to use unsecured or WEP Wi-Fi like the DS Lite and original DS, which thankfully isn't hard to set up thanks to phone hotspots. But once you've got your network, go ahead and select it, go ahead and put in your password. Now, if you don't have a password, you obviously skip that step, but let's go ahead and go through and test the connection. Now go back into Nintendo Wi-Fi connection settings and you'll see you have your network set up here. Now we're actually going to go into the network because we're going to change some stuff. We're going to scroll down until you see auto obtain DNS. We're going to click no, and then we're going to tap edit on primary DNS. Now go ahead and put this DNS in. Once you've got the DNS in, go ahead and click OK, and then click OK again. Now for secondary DNS, you don't need to put anything because it will just copy this one over to this one, so you don't need to put anything there. Now you can go ahead and test the connection. For me, the connection succeeded. If the connection does not succeed for you, make sure to check your DNS and make sure you're close enough to your router. With all that being said, let's go ahead and save the settings. Go ahead and go back again, and you can see we are now back in the options to go into the game, add a friend code, things like that. So now let's go ahead and test and see if it worked. I'm gonna go ahead and connect to WFC. And you can see, yes, it did work. We are in the options menu, and I could go ahead and get into a Mario Kart game here if I wanted to. But now let me show you how to do this on the 3DS and DSi. So guys, the DSi and 3DS have identical ways of doing this, so I'm going to show you how to do it on the 3DS, and this will apply to the DSi as well. So on both the DSi and 3DS, we're going to go into the settings, go ahead and open that. In the settings now, we're going to go to internet settings and connection settings. So guys, you can see I already have two connections configured and I have one open. If you already have all of yours taken up, just go ahead and erase one and create a new connection. Let's search for an access point. And you can see here are our networks. Go ahead and choose your network. And like I said earlier, the 3DS and DSi can use WPA networks in any DSi enhanced game online. So if you have modern Wi-Fi, you can use that in any DSi enhanced game. And if you don't know if your game is DSi enhanced, just go to Google real quick and search up if your game is or is not DSi enhanced. If it is DSi enhanced and you're using a DSi or 3DS or 2DS, you can use any modern Wi-Fi with that game online, but if it is not, you will need to use a WEP network or an unsecured network to do that. So go ahead and put your password in, go ahead and click OK, and then save your connection settings. And you can see it did work. We can go ahead and click OK. And let's go ahead and go back into the network we just set up. Go to change settings, go over one, and you're gonna see DNS here. We're going to go into that. And you see here it says auto obtain DNS. We're gonna say no and click detailed setup. So we're gonna ignore the secondary DNS. We're just gonna go into the primary one, delete all of this, and we're just gonna write this DNS in once again. Go ahead and click OK and OK again. We're gonna save and retest the connection. So we're gonna go back now, back again, and into the home screen. Now we're gonna go into the game that we put in to play online, so go ahead and do that. Now I have gone ahead and gone into Pokemon Black 2, and this whole series, Pokemon White, Black, White 2, and Black 2, those are all DSi enhanced games, so they will work with any modern Wi-Fi on the DSi and 3DS, but if you wanna play classic games on your DSi or 3DS, you can still do that, you just need to use WEP Wi-Fi and set it up within the actual game itself, in this menu, just like you would on the original DS or DS Lite. So I didn't have a save file on Pokemon Black 2, so I went on Pokemon White instead. Same situation. So to test our Wi-Fi connection, I am in the Pokemon Center, and I'm gonna go to the GTS to see if our Wi-Fi setup works. So let's go ahead and go to Global Trade and try it out. All right, there we go. If you get a message like this, just go ahead and go over it and click yes. If you see this message, just go ahead and ignore it, keep going through it. And you can see I have successfully loaded into the GTS, and I'll go ahead and search something up. We'll go ahead and search for Oshawott, since it's a pretty widely wanted Pokemon. And you can see we got someone instantly. We'll go ahead and click select. And you can see this person wants a Zekrom. Not really sure if they're gonna get that, but still, it is great to see this working in 2022, and that is exactly how you set it up. And guys, that is how you can get Nintendo Wi-Fi connection working back online with relative ease. And this will work for just about any game that ever supported online services on the Nintendo DS, as long as you're using the correct kind of Wi-Fi. So guys, if you have any questions or comments, make sure to leave them below. I will try to respond to as many as I can. But guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe if this video helped you out, because it helps the channel out a ton. And I make videos like this that you don't want to miss. Once again, thank you for watching.